In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to bring your drawings to life in just a few simple steps in Photoshop. Stay tuned and I'll show you how.
Studio Shepherd.
So to start, I'm going to create a new layer. Now select the paintbrush tool and make sure to set the brush hardness to 100%. And under swatches, I've pre-made the color palette that I want to use for my picture. So I'm going to select one of these colors and basically draw a simple picture of what we want our final image to look like. So here I'm drawing some mountains, which will be in the background, and I'm going to add this horizon line. We want this to be a solid color, so I'm going to use the paint bucket tool just to fill it in. You can scale your brush up by using the right square bracket key, and I'm going to draw some lush green meadows, and I'm going to have them rolling through here in front of my mountains. Now fast forward, I've added a riverbed with some rocks and a blue sky. In final touches, I'm going to add some clouds, and for these we can reduce the hardness of the brush and even drop the opacity a little bit. I'm not going to be too fussy with these, just indicating where I want my clouds to be. So with our picture complete, we're going to toggle on our quick mask mode by clicking the icon here, where you can use the short key Q. Make sure black is set to your foreground color, and then press Alt-Delete to fill with black. So the red now indicates our selection, and if we hit Command or Control-Shift-F, it will bring up these fade options here, where we can reduce the opacity of our fill to around 40%. Now exit your quick mask by hitting this icon again, or the short key Q. And under Window, make sure you have the contextual taskbar turned on. In this bar, click Generative Fill, and we can now add our prompt. So here I'm going to describe exactly the scene I just drew. Then click Generate. And look at that, it's turned our simple picture into a photorealistic landscape. There are a few other variations here, but I think the first one is pretty close to my painting. I can now make selections and start editing or adding to my picture. Like here I might want to add a small hut. And over here I'm going to add a small flock of sheep. And that's how to bring your drawings to life using Generative Fill in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest design tips. I'll see you in the next video.